and Robloxians. Welcome to the second annual Roblox Game Conference. My name is Eric Castle. I am the co-founder of Roblox. Some of you might know me better by my very creative username, which is eric.castle.
Yeah!
We have a lot of great events and activities for you here. I think you're gonna have a great time. But also, we're really interested in meeting you and talking with you. So any person you see with a red and black shirt, please come up, introduce yourself, tell us what you like about Roblox, tell us what you think we could improve. We really want to listen and learn, so that's very important to us, okay? Our first speaker is going to talk about Roblox and its place in the world of gaming and what sort of sets us apart from other games out there. So I think it's going to be a great talk. And it is really my great pleasure to be able to introduce him. He is the CEO and inventor of Roblox. He's not only the person who started the company, but he's also an extraordinary programmer. He wrote the first lines of code that would eventually become Roblox as we know it today. So please help me welcome onto the stage Roblox developer number one, sometimes known as Builder Man, David Baszucki! Welcome everybody! This is our second Roblox Game Conference. Last year we called it the Rally. This year we're calling it Game Conference. I think you're gonna love what we have for you. Before I start, I'd like you to have a big round of applause for Eric Castle. Introduced me as a great programmer, but actually, the super great programmer at Roblox, I think every Roblox employee here today will acknowledge it, the super programmer at Roblox is Eric Castle. So, awesome. So Eric and I, we worked really hard when we founded Roblox. Eric and I actually worked together in an office for 2 years writing software, just like you guys write Lua code today, to get the first version of Roblox up and going. And we've come an amazing distance since it was the two of us in an office to some staggering numbers of players, a staggering number of creative people, and we're gonna talk about it today. We have people here from all around the world. I've met people here from Scotland, from Sweden, from just about every state, from New Jersey. So we really appreciate you coming out to tell us about Roblox and what we're doing. And I'd like to start with just a little recap of this year. Every month, today, over 2.8 million people play on Roblox. It's a staggering, staggering number. We like hearing from all of you. I'd like to put that number in proportion. Last year, when we were here, we put up a picture of how many people we played every month. A number was south of 2 million. And we think this picture is about 1.7, 1.8 million people. 2.8 million people playing every month is basically the population of Kansas playing on Roblox every month. So, it's an enormous number, And we really appreciate it. And part of this conference here today is for every Roblox employee to really interact with you and get a feeling of how many lives we really touch, you know? How many people spend time with our product, how important we are to you. And so, just as it's fun for you, it's actually very, very valuable to us to be here today. Here's a little graph of our growth history. You can see we just organically, year by year, through you telling your friends, you know, people enjoying the products, our player count has gone up and up. Now let's talk about creative power and building power. This is a very big number. This is the amount of creative energy that is spent on Roblox every month. 36 million hours. So every employee in this room has a lot of time being spent for them out there in the Roblox community. And it kind of drives home to us how careful we have to be with the product, how safe we have to try and make it. You know, we're affecting a lot of time and a lot of lives. I'd like to put this number in perspective with a little corporate goal. If you look today at the total time spent around the world playing with physical building bricks, and you know what that is, that's Lego, Mega Bloks, Connects, Best Lock, and now Creo from Hasbro, that total time is about 600 million hours per month. Now put that in perspective with a small startup company called Roblox. We only have 17 times to go for the time spent on Roblox in virtual building land equals physical building land. That is an achievable goal for our company. And it's one thing we think about. We are all building maniacs at Roblox. I love construction toys, I love building stuff. And our goal is really to capture that same play pattern online, to be really the ultimate building environment online. If you remember last year, we talked about how the creative energy of Roblox, if harnessed, could build the Golden Gate Bridge in 2 weeks. Today, that 36 million hours could build the pyramids in 2 months. So if we could take every Robloxian and take the time they spend for 2 months, we would build the pyramids. The pyramids took about 70 million hours to build a pyramid. Last year, you created over 5 million games. And this isn't just build and save. This is 5.4 million places on Roblox that had 10 or more visits. So let's put that into perspective. If you go right now to Facebook, you'll see 18,000 games on Facebook. That's actually a pretty big number. And if you go to the App Store, you'll see about 120,000 games in the App Store. Our community blows that away. So you are all really participating in an ecosystem that is almost 50 times the amount of content being produced as that app store you hear so much about. We're starting to get interest from great advertising partners, and I will tell you, we're very careful about who we let advertise, especially for big ads on the site. Keep your eyes open towards the end of this year for another advertising partner that I think you're all going to be very excited about. You're going to love it. And finally, our revenue is growing. We pour every cent of the money we make from Builders Club, from Robux, we pour it back into the product to try to hire more great developers at Roblox. And that's a graph without numbers of our revenue history. So we appreciate very much your help in allowing us to keep building this great product. And the press is starting to take notice. Last year we had, you know, I'd say articles from less prominent news sources. Now places like Forbes and also more serious, you know, professional gaming sites are starting to notice that Roblox is really kind of unique. So, Before I finish, I think all of us in the room, all the Roblox employees, I'd like to give you guys all a big hand. Thank you all for great work. So why are we here? One reason I think a lot of you are here is, hey, what do I want to do? What's my career going to be? Some of us love gaming, some of us like other things. And I want, from me, to leave you with one message, and it kind of relates to why I started Roblox. When we started this company, Eric and I kind of took a big risk. Gaming wasn't that popular, you know, 6 or 7 years ago. It wasn't hot like it was right now. But we both loved the idea of trying to build the ultimate online kind of building system. And my guidance to all of you is start thinking about your personal passion and what's interesting to you. Okay? This is one thing that'll give you a kind of a tool for success in life. If you are working on something you love, it's a lot easier to stick with it. It's a lot easier to get really good at it. When you're having difficult times, it's easy to keep pushing through. So this is my one message to you. And I want to talk a little today about the gaming market as a whole and give you a suggestion. If you want to get into gaming, there's a lot of different ways to participate in gaming. And many of your personal passions can help you get into the gaming space. You could be an artist like Pablo, you know, Picasso, and there's a huge demand for great artists in gaming. You can be a composer like Mozart, and I'm sure many of you will ask, when are you going to have sound and music in Roblox? Hopefully someday composers will also participate in our ecosystem. You can be a business person and participate in gaming, just like Leland Stanford. So maybe you're just really interested in commerce and selling. That's fine, there's a place for you. And you can even be an economist like Milton Friedman. The Roblox economy is actually very much like the real world economy. We have tickets, we have Robux. And I would dare to say there's a lot of employees at Roblox who may be just as good as some people, you know, on the national level at understanding how economic matters work. So we're very careful in printing money at Roblox. That's an inside joke for the parents.
If you're into advertising, you can be like David Ogilvy, famous advertiser. And of course, if you're into programming, you can be a big, great programmer like Bill Gates. There is also a great opportunity for inventors to enter gaming, because the types of things games do, how they work, there's a huge opportunity for raw creativity, even if you're not a programmer, to participate in gaming. So, first point about being a game developer, maybe working for Roblox someday, is follow your passion. So let's look at the gaming space. My prediction is, because games are so interactive, you don't just sit and watch or listen, because you actually participate, you build, you create. My prediction is gaming someday will be bigger than any other form of media. Today gaming is about a $60 billion market. I believe someday it'll be bigger than movies and TV. And part of what Roblox is all about is, unlike the way games are built today, where they're built by studios, we believe that Roblox users are ultimately the creators of most games in the world. And just like on YouTube today, most video is created by consumers, we believe in the future most games will be created by your average user, just like you all do today. So the vision of Roblox is really, we want to power kind of the consumer, hobbyist, student, educator, learning game developer as part of this gaming revolution. And the growth rate of the space that you're participating in, which is user-generated games, is much higher than any segment. There are many games that are starting to touch on user construction, building, creating. You know, we can all name 4, 5, or 6 of them. That space, which Roblox is a part of, which is user-created gaming, is growing much faster than any other gaming segment. So, if you're into gaming, it is a growing industry. I think there'll be lots of jobs in gaming 2, 3, 4, 6 years from now. So whether you're in grade school, middle school, or high school, I think there'll be opportunity out there. So how do I get into gaming? We have a set of values at Roblox that we use when we're hiring Roblox employees to try and find people that are kind of consistent with what Eric and I had when we started. And there's two of them that I'd like to touch on that I think apply a lot to, you know, ultimately how might I work at a gaming company. The first one is self-organized. What does that mean? This doesn't really mean clean up your desk or anything like that. It means take initiative in whatever your passion happens to be. So if you like music and composing, start composing some music, you know, record some songs, put them up on a website, follow and really immerse yourself, not just in going to your music lessons, but doing your own thing with music. Same thing with programming. Just like many of you are doing with Roblox today, take some initiative, build some games on Roblox, maybe make your own website, show a personal passion, and self-organize, because a lot of what we look for are people who've not just kind of, you know, done the standard thing, but have kind of gone out of their way to get into what they're passionate about. And the second one I'd stress is work hard. If you read about Silicon Valley, you'll hear a lot about, whoa, this just happened, or this is awesome. Behind most of these companies, there's a lot of hard work. And the media usually doesn't capture the hard work aspect. The media usually captures kind of the glamour, you know, the rags to riches success aspect. So I would say you also have to work hard. We have three other values that are also important that I'm not going to stress here as well. I would note that our fourth one, we really stress at Roblox respecting all of you, the customer, because we know that we kind of interact with your lives. So, if you're interested in gaming, self-organize and work hard.
All right, we are now ready for Roblox Jeopardy, led by our own Josh Lexke. John, as you know, is also known as Telemon. He is the very first employee to actually work at the Roblox office. Many of you may not know that John has also held the longest running, top grossing game on TV of all time. He has a multimedia empire, composing books, music, and television. We're really happy to have him here today. Thank you. John, take it away.
How do you like my Photoshop skills? That's my head on Electrodeck's body. I think it's an improvement. All right, guys. So we're gonna start off by meeting our contestants. First, we have Zane, AKA Genius 5. He's 17, he's visiting us from Oklahoma. He's best known by the Roblox staff as the guy who decorated our office. We've got a lot of artwork from him. And earlier, he tried to bribe me to rig this game. All right. Sitting to his immediate right, we have Alex, AKA Alex Neutron. You guys may remember, he won our Game Developer of the Year award last year. He's very accomplished. He runs socialmeeps.com, is a site that he's running right now.
.net.
Socialmeeps.net. You need to spring for the better domain name. Everyone assumes it's .com. Anyway, maybe with the thousands of dollars you're making from that, you could lock down the .com domain. He's a very successful businessman. Sitting to his right, we have Brandon, AKA Cowbear. Brandon is 16 and has been playing Roblox for 4 years. He's visiting us from Massachusetts. He's the founder and CEO of Double Trouble Studios, who you may have noticed is selling books out in the lobby. And that company is very successful for you, isn't it, Brandon?
Yeah,
very successful. So we'd like to shout about Brandon's story to anyone who will listen. And last but not least, we have Nick, aka Hiccup, or is it Hiccup? Hiccup, 7989. He's been playing Roblox since 2007, and he loves graphic design and using his creativity. All right, so we've met the contestants. Should we play Jeopardy? Let's start the game. All right, first let's introduce the categories. We have terms of art, history, virtual greats. Those are questions about virtual goods. Rich and famous, where am I? And keywords. And in that last category, every answer to every question is a Lua keyword. All right, so we did a rock, paper, scissors tournament before the start of the show. And Genius 5 actually won this for us. Zane, you want to pick the first question?
Thank you, John. History for 100, please.
Can we have history for 100, please? Oh, hold on. Oh, there we go. The first Roblox conference was held here in 2011. Green.
The Exploratorium.
Can you please phrase that in
what is form of a question?
What is the Exploratorium? That is correct for 100 points for Green. All right. Brandon, you have control of the board. What category would you like?
Rich and Famous for 100.
Can we have Rich and Famous for 100, please? Roblox co-founder and chief scientist. Yellow.
Eric Cassell.
Eric Cassell is the question, is the answer for 100 points. All right. Give that man 100 points. I thought I heard that in the question. Did you say what is?
No.
We're not gonna split hairs here. I was just giving that guy a hard time before about me. All right, Alex, sorry. Zane, what do you want?
History for 200, please.
And we have history for 200. This is the only game on Roblox to ever hit 6,000 concurrent players. Blue.
What is the town of Roblox now?
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Orange.
What is the, I have the name.
Roblox building game. What is the Roblox, welcome to Roblox building.
I'm sorry, you're out of time and wrong. Anyone else want to vote? All right. The answer is what is the 2012 Roblox Egg Hunt? We actually had more than 6,000 concurrent players in that. So that's going to cost you a handful of points. And if I'm not mistaken, Zane, you are still in control of the board. So why don't you think about what question you want while Cyram tallies up the scores here.
Terms of art for 100.
Terms of art for 100, Cy, when you get a chance. A 3D pixel. So we can use some help from the audience if anyone knows the answer, or if you just want to be annoying and like make the your thinking sound. Shout it out. All right, Blue.
What is it possible?
That is correct for 100 points. So, the category of terms of art, you may have figured out at this point, all those answers are technical terms of art, not visual art or anything like that. Hiccup, you want to...
Can I take virtual grades for 100?
Can we have virtual grades for 100, please? It's darker than RGB 000, and it steals life from your enemies. What more is there to say? Blue.
What is the dark heart?
That is correct for 100 points. What is dark heart? Notice that that was in quotes. Very clever. All right, you're out of the pit. What do you want?
Can I take virtual grades for 200?
We have virtual grades for 200, please. Warning, this soda contains 0% real blocks and may be habitable. Blue again.
What is the Bloxy Cola?
That is the Bloxy Cola for 200. All right, Nick. You did that one. You mean 300?
Yeah, 300.
Virtual rates for 300. How great can they get? This is the first gear item ever published. Green.
The Roblox staff of, some wood staff.
No, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Blue.
What is the Brigand Sword?
What is the Brigand Sword for 300? Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Nick, you're really on a tear with these virtual greats. You know a lot about your
catalog knowledge is very sharp.
You want to continue with this category?
Yeah, virtual greats for 400.
Virtual greats for 400. The various incarnations of Clockwork's teapots are based on this famous teapot from the field of computer graphics. Man, these got hard really fast. Yeah, all the 4s and 500s are kind of brutal. Anybody in the audience want to shout it out? You know it? It's a little arcane. Alright. Sorry, you guys are out of time. The correct answer is, what is the Utah teapot?
Yeah.
That's what Clockwork adopted. All right. Nick, you still have control of the board because no one answered that last question correctly.
You want to go for that last one?
Rich and Famous for 200.
We're going to back away from the 5 minutes. All right, Rich and Famous for 200. More than 12 million people have survived his disasters. Lou. That is correct. Who is the furry fox? I'm going to give you credit for that because you're going there. All right. Give him 200 points. Blue, you are destroying it. Rich and Famous for 300, please. This was the first player to achieve 1 million place visits in January 2009. Green.
Mike. Who is Mike?
Yes. Who is Mike D? I think it's Mike D, but Mike is acceptable. Very good. Brandon, you have stolen control of the board from Nick.
What do you want to do?
Where am I for 100?
Where am I for 100? Where am I? Blue.
Where is Crossroads?
Where is Crossroads? That is correct for 100 points.
Where am I for 200?
Can we have where am I for 200? Where am I? This game has gotten a lot of play recently. Green.
What is Crazy Man's Free Flight?
That is correct. What is Free Flight? Crazy Man 32 has a lot of good games. Brandon, I believe you are in control.
Could I have History for 300?
History for 300, please. The Roblox currency exchange was added to the website in November of this year. Ooh.
What is...
Sorry, that's incorrect. Orange.
What is 2010?
Sorry, that's also incorrect. You already buzzed in orange, so we got yellow here.
What is 2007?
Oh, this is brutal. No! Brandon, you wanna...
What is 2011?
Oh! All right, you all lose points. That's... The correct answer is, what is 2008, I believe. Yes. I had trouble remembering this one, too, so I practiced this one. That will cost you all 300 points. And so, while Sai is doing the math, Double Trouble Studios, Brandon, how did you come up for the name for that?
I am an identical twin, and we used to have t-shirts that said Double Trouble on them.
Alright, is it really twice as much trouble, or is it like four times more trouble when you have two?
No, he's not a
I don't know, I guess it depends on what we're doing.
Okay, so you're sticking with Double. I respect that. If I am not mistaken,
I think Brandon is still in control of the game. Is that correct?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. You want to pick a category, Brandon?
Could I have where am I for 300?
Where am I for 300? The question is, where am I? Blue.
What is Dry Blocks Unlimited?
That is Dry Blocks Unlimited for 300 points. All right, Nick.
Where am I for 400?
Where am I for 400, please? Where am I now? Lou.
What is Roblox?
I'm sorry, that is not correct. Anyone else? I'm sorry, we're out of time. The correct answer is, what is World War II? Battle of Corinthian? 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 I would have accepted either. Nick, I believe you're in control. Oh, we're afraid of the keyboards category. Very wise. That's an art. For 200, please. Yes, that one. In physics, an upward force that makes some parts float. Ring.
What is velocity?
I'm sorry, that's not correct. Yellow.
What is propulsion?
I'm sorry, no. Anybody? What is buoyancy for 200? Little help from the audience. You should thank the audience for that one. What is buoyancy? All right, Nick, you are absolutely tearing it up. You have 600 points. Everyone else is in the hole. Do you wanna? What do you wanna do next? Rich and famous. Rich and famous for 400. Man, you too is the clue. Anna Minus, yes, I will take that for 400.
Anna Minus,
the famous command util plugin that lets you build amazing things in Roblox Studio. It's been very inspirational, actually, for the team working on Studio. Nick.
Virtual grades for 500.
Let's do the last virtual grades. This hat's name is Undying Glory in ancient Greek.
Is this the dumbest?
Hello. Wow, you know the entire Roblox staff thought no one would get this. Yes, that is the answer. What is the class
of the futon?
Very good. Well played. Your knowledge of Roblox Arcana is unparalleled. What category would you like now? We're out of virtual grades, I'm sorry.
Rich and famous for 500.
Rich and famous for 500. Iron Enforcer's famous Iron Cafe has this many million visits. Yellow.
What is 3 million?
What is 3 million? I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The closest integer million. Pretty soon people will have looked it up. All right, blue. What is 1 million? I'm sorry, that's also incorrect. This just became anyone's game. Who wants to make a move? Green.
What is 6 million?
What is 6 million? That is also incorrect. All right, so Brandon, do you want to wager a guess here, or do you want to call it quits on this question? Oh, no, I'm sorry, Brandon. Alex is the only one who hasn't buzzed in yet.
Oh, boy.
No, I'm sorry, you guys are out of time. The correct answer is what is 5 million? So you danced all around the answer. Find the answer. It's a shame. So that will cost everyone except for Alex, who is orange, 500 points. Man, I am just really, I make mean Jeopardy questions, I guess, is what's going on here.
This is torture.
It's torture. But it's for a good cause. How about, Nick, good call, you go.
Where am I for
500? Where am I? This place has a 250,000 visits, so it is not famous, but not obscure. Got this.
Sharon Adam.
Yes. Audience, do we know where this is? We're out of time on that one. The correct answer is, where is Wits End? You're at your wits end, racking your mind for that one. Nick. Oh, no. We didn't do that one. You gotta click the back. There we go. Nick.
History for 400,
please. The first post to the Roblox blog was made in this year.
Yellow.
What is 2006?
Nailed it! What is 2006 is the answer. December 2006, I believe. Alex, what do you want to do here? I think you can still overtake Blue.
Oh boy. Let's do keywords for 100.
Keywords, they're venturing into the keywords category. In Lua, the shortest branch control keyword.
is N. No, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Anyone else?
What is if?
What is if is the answer
and the unlikely lexical pairing. What is if? Yes. 100. Brandon. Can we give him some points, please?
No, I'm confused.
Yes. The answer is what is if. I know, Jeopardy is a weird game where I give you a clue and then you answer in the form of a question. Would you like to do keywords or you want to do
keywords for 200?
Alright. That's a leading question, I guess.
This keyword is on your keyboard.
I saw orange buzzing, yes.
Alex. End. What is end?
What is end? Yes, I would have also accepted the return for 200 points.
Alex, what do you want to do?
Keywords for 300.
Keywords for 300. They got the hang of this one now, guys. This little code snippet prints 2 unless B is declared using this keyword. Anybody want to help him out? You want to do a lot of little scripting? Everyone that knows the answer is actually at the hackathon right now. No one wants to guess. Okay. Guys, we're out of time. The answer is local. So if that was defined in the local scope, then it would be undefined in the global scope. Yes. Keywords.
I think Alex is still in control, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay. I'll do keywords for 400.
Keywords for 400.
This controversial keyword is used to jump execution here. Notice the funky formatting on here.
Orange.
Break. What is break?
What is break? I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Anyone else?
I shouldn't know this until I looked it up. You were gonna buzz in until I said that. That's funny.
You guys are out of time, I believe.
Yeah, what's a surprise to me? Lua has a go-to keyword.
Really?
Yeah. And that's how you define a label in Lua, is with those colons like that.
But that's just good. It means if you're not using go-to, you're probably writing solid keyword.
Alex.
500 keywords.
Keywords for 500. The table type implements associative arrays in Lua. This is the only invalid key.
You're adding code.
The audience can chime in at any time here.
What? You're talking writing code, saying that you're not code. So you don't know. There he's lab code.
So right here's code.
Only invalid key. Alright, I'm sorry, you guys are out of time. The correct answer is nil. But you can use any value as a key except for nil. And Alex, you are still in control of this board.
Keywords went south really quickly, didn't it, Alex?
All that's left are really hard ones.
Alright, terms of art for 300.
Terms of art for 300, please. In Roblox, heart motion updates in a multiplayer game are smoothed out using this common technique.
So, it would be a term of art in the field of computer networking. Orange.
What is a packet?
Sorry.
What is I don't know? What is I don't know?
Nick's looking pretty confident over there. Alright guys, you're out of time. The correct answer was, what is interpolation? That's when you take sparse data points and you kind of make up the ones in between.
Killing me. It wasn't a blog post, though.
Yeah, so a lot of these terms of art I've stolen from blog posts. Buoyancy, this one, yes, that's where I get all my ideas, is the blog.
I believe Alex still controls this board.
History for 500.
History for 500. This one's mean. The Roblox.com domain name was registered in January of this year. Orange buzzed in first.
Okay. What is 2005?
What is 2005? I'm sorry. It's not correct. Green.
What is 2004?
2004 for 500 points of Brandon.
Yes.
It's tricky because it's way before there was a website to be seen. Yes. All right, Brandon, you stole control of the board.
I so many juice from.
You want it for 400 or 500?
400.
All right. In 2 minutes, you'll have done both of them. Okay. In computer science, this allows a function to access variables outside of its immediate lexical scope. Some of us didn't, but it was before. It wasn't again if you want to answer the question. Oh, now you're thinking twice about it. Computer science. This allows a function to access variables outside its immediate lexical scope. Art. Language feature of Aruba. Anybody? I think we are out of time. And the answer is, oh, at the buzzer if you want it. We're playing a nice game, so I'm going to let that slide. The answer is, what is a closure? What is a closure? We've also accepted up value. And let's finish out terms of art. A rendering technique for efficiently approximating the shadows due to ambient occlusion in real time.
Killing us.
Killing us. Nobody reads the blog. I'm giving a talk here in like an hour. If you're really upset about it, you can come over here and boo at me while I'm doing this. Hello. What is dynamic lighting? No, I'm sorry. Anybody else? Correct answer is, what is screen space ambient occlusion? That's how Roblox does its shadows. All right, let's look at the final score, shall we? We have Alex with a negative 500. You did better than some of our developers did last night when we were practicing. Orange is in the hole for 1,500 points. If I were to bet, you would owe me money. We have Brandon with a negative 100. And the winner by a mile is Nick, aka Hiccup789. Everyone who played today will win a fabulous red top hat that we're giving out to our nominees for the Roblox Hall of Fame, very exclusive virtual item. And Nick will be taking home a fabulous virtual trophy, bound to be worth a couple of Robux someday. Thanks for playing, guys.
Created on Roblox in the last year.
Yeah. In addition to that, you guys have created over 3 million models, 2 million t-shirts, and over 250,000 each of shirts, pants, and groups.
So by comparison, the AAA level studios, which are the major game companies, have created less than 1,000 games in the last year. So you guys are blowing them out of the water, and that's great.
Congratulations.
So here we're showing you some places and items made by people in this very room. And we wanted to make sure to acknowledge you guys before we launch into the award ceremony, because you guys coming out here, you're the winners of the day. You're gonna be able to tell people, I went to RGC 2012, and nobody else is ever gonna be able to say that who wasn't here today. So thanks a lot for coming out, and give yourself a round of applause.
All of the nominees today will be receiving the RGC 2012 top hat, and the winners in each of the categories will get the RGC 2012 Roblox statuette.
Great, so we have the hackathon today. They're still tallying the vote to see who was the winner. It will be announced later by Dave.
And all of the hackathon winners will also receive the Roblox statue. Mm-hmm. So our first category today is Best RPG. RPGs are very popular on Roblox and run the gamut from intergalactic space battles to dragon fantasy fights. Here are some of the best. We chose these based on staff preference, frequency of updates to games, and visit count.
Right. So our first nominee is Legend of the Shattered Rune by Blob34. So here we have a fantasy RPG where you can go on quests and raise your level and get different powers. We like how he used terrain here. And also, fans of the game can join his group and learn more about it.
All right, our Our next nominee is Negative 22 Degrees and Dropping by Redneck Bricksman. So this game is a wasteland genre game, sort of surviving the apocalypse. Redneck Bricksmith is focused on realistic style games, as you can see from the atmosphere in this one.
And the next nominee is Lord of Ranger's Cape by Range Malud. So this is another fantasy genre game. And so he's already working on a sequel, despite the popularity of this game, which is called Dawn of Destructius. And the winner is Legend of the Shattered Dreamway Block 34. Congrats to Block 34. So Block 34 told us that the most important thing in game design to him is gameplay, and that's a belief that we also agree in. So the next category is Best First-Person Shooter. First-person shooters are games where you shoot them up. We have lots of different genres of those on Roblox, from Wild West to space and beyond.
All right, our first nominee is Paintball by Daxter33. In this game, you can join and then you're assigned with different missions. So you can have a capture the flag game, there's a team swap game. In addition to that, there's just a regular sort of shoot 'em up version of the game.
And the next nominee is Base Wars the Land by Dark886. So this is a military genre game with land and air warfare, lots of different classes. The longer you play the game, the more classes open up to you.
All right, our final nominee for this category is Call of Robloxia 5, Roblox at War by Lido Zinnemann. So this is a classic military shooter. He has scripted a GUI system so you can pick your weapon and your class when you start playing, and as you play longer, you can sort of rank up. And the winner is Call of Robloxia 5, Roblox at War by Lido Zinnemann. Our next category is Excellence in Construction. So how we picked these was just Roblox favorites. Our staff are in the games all the time, and these are some of the most beautiful things we've seen created on Roblox in the past year. Our first nominee is BMW M5 Series Concept by Geico 480. So Geico 480 created each of these cars. They're each made of 2,000 parts, which he C-framed together to capture all of the details of the BMW M5 series.
All right, our next nominee is Warrior Cats by Mandica. And the staff picked this game because of the terrain and how beautiful it is. This is one of the most detailed environments we've seen on Roblox in quite a while in a playable game.
All right, and our final nominee for this category is Legerete de la Liberté by Stuntman007. So here, Stuntman 007 created a Victorian-era airship. You'll notice the attention to detail in the woodworking in the ceiling and on the ground. All right. The winner of this category is Legerete de la Liberté by Stuntman 007.
Category is most active group. This was determined by number of new members in the last year, quantity of wall posts in the last year, and overall size.
All right, our first nominee is Vortex Security by Eric Latios. Vortex Security is one of the largest groups on Roblox. It's a war clan and features a training ground where you can earn promotions.
The next nominee is the Roblox Assault Team owned by Color Theory. So this group has over 75,000 members and 9 subdivisions that are different groups.
And our final nominee today is First Encounter Assault Recon, owned by Sonic the Hedgehog XX, also known as Fear. This is another war clan, and is in fact currently the largest war clan on Roblox. Fear.
And the winner is Vortex Security by Eric Latios. Vortex Security has over 90,000 members. Over 65,000 people have joined the group in the past year, and they have over 250,000 wall posts, so a very active group.
Our next category is Best Fan Blog. So these are news sites and fan sites we found out on the internet that we thought were particularly engaging and active. The first nominee is Rogo Magazine. So this is a magazine that they put out in issues. They have contests and a very active staff. And one of the things we like most about them is that they take the magazine and publish it as a model that you can read in-game. And that's quite a feat.
All right, next nominee is Lua Learners by CoolBob44. I think CoolBob44 is actually here today. So in this website, new and experienced Lua scripters can join, ask each other questions, share their projects, find teammates to work on projects. The website itself has over 1,500 members, and the corresponding Roblox group has over 3,000 members.
And the next nominee is Roblox News by Arborator. This news magazine is run out of England, where Arborator is from. It's a very active editor group, and they do contests and updates pretty much constantly. And the winner is Roblox News by Arborator.
All right, our next category is Best Advertisement. So as you may or may not know, Roblox users are able to create their own advertisements, which we then show on Roblox. They are for groups, shirts, all kinds of things. And so how we picked the winner of this category was the ad had to show over 300,000 times in the past year, and then it's just the straight click-through rate, so the number of clicks versus the number of impressions.
And our first nominee is Survive the Weird Disasters by Nearly Dead. So in this ad, he's trying to get you to come to the Survive the Disasters place. And you can see there at the bottom that the worst disaster is Rick Astley.
Our next nominee is the Get Drawn Shirt by Lunar Hidden. In this ad, he's advertising his shirt design skills.
And the next nominee is Roblox Chair Racing by Speedy Seed. Speedy Seed fans in the audience. All right, so here he's trying to get you to come to his very popular and amusing chair racing place. He's got Chuck Norris and SpongeBob in there.
All right. The winner of this category is Get Drawn Shirt by Lunar Eden. This ad had a 4.41% click-through rate, and just so you guys are aware of how amazing that is, in 2011, over the whole internet, the average click-through rate was between 0.1 and 0.3%, so we did more than 10 times better than everyone else on the internet.
Okay, so our next category is Best Video. So we went onto YouTube and looked for the best videos we could find about Roblox that were posted in the last year, and this is what we found.
Our first nominee is The Elder Trolls of Robloxia by David.
You should have asked. They're already here. The Elder Scrolls told of their return. Their defeat was merely a delay. Of the time after Oblivion opened. When the sons of Skyrim would spill their own blood. No one wanted to believe they didn't exist. And when the truth finally was gone, it daunted fire.
Okay, so that trailer is actually a few minutes long, and you can catch all of it on YouTube, an amusing trailer of the Skyrim game. So the next nominee is Roblox Row Wars trailer by Vactus.
Oh.
Tommy is The Beauty of Roblox by Tony22. Our videos are being weird. All right, well, you can check out the rest of that one on YouTube.
Yeah, we will post these videos on our blog, so you can check them out.
And the winner is? Trolls. Elder Trolls of Roblox. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, our next category is
Staff Pick.
Staff Pick.
For Game Developer of the Year. So this is just, we sent out a survey to everybody who works at Roblox and sort of asked them, what's the best game you've been playing this year? Who's your favorite developer? And this is what we got.
The first nominee is CrazyMan32 for Stranded. So this game starts with a great hook. You crash landed in your plane and you have to survive. What the developers particularly liked about this game were the cutscenes and the system where you have to collect tokens to get past checkpoints, which had not been seen in Roblox before.
All right. Our next nominee for this category is PyDude777 for Epic Mining 2. So in this game, you go down to the Roblox Pixel Mines with your pickaxe, looking for precious gems and oil. When you find them, you can go back up to the refinery and sell them to get money to use on virtual upgrades for the game.
And our next nominee is Braden99 for World War II Battle of Carentan. So this is a historical military game with over 5 million visits. It has a highly detailed environment. You can play Axis or Allies. And the winner is CrazyMan32. The next category is User's Choice User of the Year. So a few weeks ago, we put out a survey to the users, to the community, to find out the other users that they were most favored of. Sorry. Just to pick their favorite other users.
All right.
The first nominee is Dark886, creator of Base Wars The Land.
Next up is CrazyMan32, creator of Stranded, Free Flight, last year's Perilous Skies, and Tumble.
Next nominee is Serena, creator of Catalog Heaven.
And the winner is Serena. All right, as Becky mentioned, we sent out a survey. Over 17,000 of you guys responded, and here is the game that you guys think is the best of the year. Our first nominee is Catalog Heaven by Serenov. So in this game, you can try on anything in the Roblox catalog, hats, shirts, pants, gear, and play with your friends and sort of try things out before you buy them.
Our next nominee is Base Wars The Land by Dark886. So, in this game, here we have another look at the game. You can see the two team system, some of the weapons, terrain, and vehicles that he has put into this place to make it so popular.
All right, and our final nominee today for this category is The Complex by Spyro372. So Spyro created a town and complex for users to sort of live and role play in. In addition to the town, there are over 300 badges that users can earn based on other popular players.
And the winner is Base Wars The Land by Dark886. All right, so Dark886 does all of his programming from Hong Kong, where he lives.
All right, so this is our final category today, Game of the Year.
Yes, so this was determined solely by a number of visits. So here we go.
All right, our first nominee is Survive the 87 Disasters by The Furry Fox. So in this game, you compete to survive a series of humorous disasters that include giant ducks, killer tacos, meteor showers, and very recently he's added the trampoline of death.
And our next nominee is Sword Fighting Tournament by The Gamer 101. So this is a randomly generated combat map, free-for-all battle. If you want to beat the other opponents, you can go buy the Gamer 101's t-shirts to get power-ups.
All right. And the final nominee is Call of Robloxia 5, Roblox at War by Lito Zinnemann. So Lito Zinnemann scripted all of the weapons in this game himself, and in addition to that is looking into creating a ray casting system, which would allow him to determine when your opponents were hit more accurately. And the winner with over 6 million visits is Call of Robloxia 5, Roblox at War.
So congratulations to all of this year's winners, and thanks for joining us at the Roblox Hall of Fame 2012.
A round of applause to the next everyone else. Great, fantastic. And final presentation and wrap up of the day, David Baszucki, CEO and founder.